All right. Now, let's hope this works. Come on. Okay, that hurt a little. Well, the good news is, at least nothing bad happened. For once. Oh, why did I have to open my big mouth? Huh. What do you know? I didn't land on my head. Huh. I guess it's been all this time's been lucky. I guess you could say I'm agile like a cat. Well, oh, let's see. Where am I? Let's see. Clear skies, on a really tall building. Oh, I think I might know where I am. This must be my dad's dimension. Huh. So this is the dimension Dad always talked about. Huh. Well, it's very nice. Well, I better get going. What the? Why can't I use my magic? Or my aura for that matter? I think I know what might have happened. Dang it. When I went through that portal, it must have drained. Aimed my anti-magic and a bit of my aura. Well, the good news is it didn't drain at all. The bad news is that I'm gonna have to wait a while for it to recharge. And if I tried to use it now, anti-magic would probably go haywire. You know, without the use of my aura to control it. Well, I guess there's no point in crying about it. Let's see, on the amount of magic I used. I guess it might take an hour or so. Oh, and I better stay up here. Here for the time being. I think just to be safe. Because from what I've heard from my dad, the last time he came here, the place was in chaos. Let's see. Might as well. Hello everyone, I'm your host, Slut the Detector, and I'm back again for another video. Due to some unforeseen circumstances, I will be doing my latest review here in the future of MLP, the Generation 5 Dimension. Well, anyway, today I will be reviewing the new movie, well, not so new anymore, MLP Generation 5 Make a Mark. Anyway, let's begin. For the Make Your Mark movie, I have to say, it was quite interesting to see how things went. And it was also a refresher, sure to get a chance to see all the characters again. Though I have to say, the animation is less higher quality than the movie. But hey, it's a movie. There's bound to be higher quality animation than a cartoon. Anyway, first, let's start off with the characters. And, well, I have to say, it was pretty nice to get a chance to see them all, especially in the new animation. And Pip is Pippy as usual. Izzy as wild as ever. Sunny, calm, cool, and collected. Hitch always being followed by animals. It was pretty fun to see them all. Alright, next up would have to be the animation and quality, as well as the story. Well, I have to say, it wasn't that bad, actually. Well, I don't know why many people have so many problems with the storyline. Sure, it's a bit cliche and all, but hey, it's the beginning. What do you expect? Plus, it's allowing the new generation to learn the old ways. And, well, the story was not nice. I will give it where credit is due, but sometimes it was a bit bland. Can't say I'm not thrilled, but meh. Like I said, it's the beginning. And to be fair, Air Sprout was a bit obnoxious. And, well, the new version, Jenna Sprout, wasn't anything to write home about. But hey, at least they learned a bit of conflict, even though it was a bit cheesy. Meh. But it's still allowed for a bit of character growth and to see how the magic looks in this new future of Equestria. In a way, it's quite interesting to see how the magic works. It's kind of like a recycle center, where the happiness of others flows the magic, and then the magic flows right back in, into the pose, which is quite intriguing. And I really liked how they used it to based off of real life. Back again to the recycling center idea. Who knows? Maybe they'll expand on this idea a bit more in the future. But hey, it's quite interesting. And also, why the heck does a disharmony in magic now cause random whiffs in the ground? And as well as magic disappearing? Okay, I get harmony is important, but jeez, that was something or other when we saw it in the trailer, but now seeing it in the show, yeah, that's just wow. Oh, and I do have to say they could have handled it a bit better, but all in all, it was quite fun. And we also get to see the new dragon for the series, Sparkaroni. And like I said in the previous video, you know, Sunny says their dragons have not been seen in 1,000 years. Well, this should make some interesting content and for later on for the show. And like I said before, in the other video as well, the new villain for the series, huh? Well, this would be interesting. I wonder what possibilities could they have for this main nightmare. Well, only time will tell. Anyway, since we're coming close to the end, oh no, I rate this show 4 out of 5. It was intriguing and nice to see story and plotline put to use, since there are many different ways to retell a story, after all. Well, many people say a picture says 1,000 words, sometimes a story can do the same. But there is one thing that stops it from reaching a 5, and that is a bit of the somewhat of the stale plot. And the animation was a bit flat. But all in all, it's only just the beginning. No need to rush. And who knows what may happen in the future. Well, it's been fun. Now I need to find a way to get home. After all, the Owl Star hasn't been up yet. That solves the issue. Well, I hope you all have a pleasant day, everyone. This is Slutty Detector, signing off!